Hey guys, sorry about this. This is going to be maybe a little disjointed. I ended up accidentally recording the entire original podcast without sound, so I'm going to be doing this by hand. What we're going to be talking about today is property of logarithms, and specifically how we can move them around, manipulate them, and break them apart. The first property is the product property. The log of a product equals the sum of the logs of the two factors. And the one thing to remember with all of this is that logarithms, at its basics, like we talked about, are essentially exponents. So if you remember the exponent rules, x to the m times x to the n is going to be the same thing as x to the m plus n. We're going to have something very similar here too, because again, we're talking that there are some form of exponents. So again, to go back, I believe the basics of what a log is, the basic definition of an exponential form of going back and forth, y equals, let's say, m or b to the x power. That's going to be the equivalent of x is equal to the log base b of y. So again, a log is essentially an exponent. And because of that, the properties of logarithms are going to be very, very similar to the properties of exponents. So what the product property says that if I have a log base b of x times y, that's the same thing as the log base b of x time or plus the log base b of y. Okay, so much like the product of two exponential equations is, see, there you go. Much like, you know, the product of the same bases ends up equaling the sum of their exponents, same thing here. The log of a product equals the separate logs themselves. Now, for a couple of examples, let's say we have log base 9 of x. See, this is why you do it right the first time, folks. Log base 9 of 3x. That's going to equal the log base 9 of 3 plus the log base 9 of x. And again, as I said, this is going to be something where you're going to probably be playing around with this a little bit, and you're not exactly sure how that's going to play out until we actually get into it. So you may be going through the motions, getting everything right, but it's not going to feel like you're doing anything that you know. That's okay. And then this, the reason why you would do something like this is potentially, let's say, you know, you want to know what x is. Log base 9 of 3, you know. Log base 9 is, you know, 9 to what power is equal to 3. The square root of 9 is 3, so b would be 1 half. So in this case, this would actually equal 1 half plus log base 9 of x. And you can manipulate things that way, but we'll get more into that next week. As another example, let's say we have log base a of 2 times y times z. Then again, that's the product. It's just going to equal this, the sum of the logs of each factor. So that's going to be log base a of 2 plus log base a of y plus log base a of z. And that's your answer. That's it. Now they're going to ask you to go in both directions. And so, for example, they will either ask you to expand something, which would be like what we have on the left, into expanded form, or they're going to ask you to simplify into a single logarithm, in which case you're going to take everything that they give you and you're going to put it into a single log. So in this case, log base a of 3 plus log base a of x plus log base a of x. You say, okay, that's the log base a of, and then the quantity, 3 times x times x. And then you could obviously simplify that into log base a of 3x squared. And we'll talk more about what happens with exponents later, because that's actually, again, probably the most important factor of, logs. Next one is the quotient property. And much like, remember how they have, if you have exponents, where if you're subtracting or if you're doing quotients, it's like subtracting exponents, it's the same thing here. So if I have log base b of x divided by y, that's going to be the same thing as log base b of x minus log base b of y. And again, pretty straightforward. So if you see a division symbol, you know subtraction is coming up. Dividing on the inside is equal to subtracting on the outside. Now, the one thing to remember here is, sorry for the announcement, is the fact that neither of those are equal to the log base b of x over the log base b of y. Okay, it's not a log over a log. If you have a log over a log, you can't do this. It has to be the log of a quotient. The quotient has to be on the inside of the log, not taking the, you know, dividing two logs together. It's not the same. In fact, yeah, it's important enough. Let's put some stars by it. Okay, a couple of examples. So they're going to say expand, and then they're going to show you something in, you know, simplified form. So in this case, expand log base b of x over 3. So you can get log base b of x minus log base b of 3. And that is it. Ta-da. Now you can start combining these two ideas together. We're going to eventually get all three of them going together, but which is why it's 5.0. But you could do something where, and again, parentheses are going to be very, very important with this in terms of how you line things up and where things go from there. So let's say we do log base 6 of the quantity 2 divided by 3x. So again, you're going to do what you normally do. It's going to be numerator divided by the denominator. So log base 6 of 2 minus log base 6 of 3x. And then after you're done with that, you can break up the log base 6 of 3x. Now, the real tempting thing is for people to do what I'm writing down here on the bottom. Log base 6 of 2 minus log base 6 of 3 plus the log base 6 of x, because, you know, log of 3 times x is log of 3 plus log of x. But remember, you're subtracting all of that. So you're going to put in separate parentheses of log base 6 of 3 plus log base 3 of x. And then it's going to turn into down here, instead of being, you know, plus log base 6 of x, it's going to actually be minus log base 6 of x by the time you distribute out that subtraction. So please make sure that you do that and watch that. Parentheses are going to be your friend. And again, one of those times where if you're going too fast or you think it's too simple, you're probably going to end up making mistakes. All right, this is where all the money's made in logarithms. This is the whole reason why we do these things. The log of a power equals the exponent times the log of the base. And I'll show you why this works after I show you the initial thing. So log base b of x to the m power equals m times log base b to the x. So that whole variable, that whole m, just slides out front. And that's why this is so important, because if you take the log of something with a variable up on the top, the variable will now come out front and now you can deal with it. So as an example of how some of this proof works, this isn't going to be an exact proof, but it gives you an idea. Let's say we have log base b of x squared. We could rewrite that as log base b of the quantity x times x, and then using the product property, have that equal log base b of x plus log base b of x. So then that, I've got two log base b's of x's, so I've got two log base b of x. And so what ends up happening is that we just jump from the front to the end. The number up front is essentially how many times that, you know, in this case variable x happens, and so we can just go from there. And that's, you know, the big thing that I alluded to earlier. So as an example to expand, let's say I have log base 3 of 5 to the x power. And this is an example of where, you know, it's equal to something else, let's say. But anyway, the x is going to go out front. So this, when you expand it, is going to equal x times log, not lag, Mr. Hayes, log. Thank you. Log base 3 of 5. So now what you can do is that if you knew how much log base 3 of 5 was, you could divide both sides by it if this was equal to a separate number, and then you can see what x is. And that's the whole reason why logarithms are the wonderful thing that they are. That's why we go through and do that, and that's why logarithms are a unit that you study and it's extremely helpful. And this is the exam. This is the assignment that we ended up doing last year. I'm showing you this more because of the cool animation. Because after all, who doesn't like Babe the Blue Ox and Paul Bunyan wrestling? So, anyway, we'll talk to you later. Thanks.